Make sure you have your materials ready. Now that you have the proper materials, the next step is to place the cord in the correct spot located in the back of the hot plate. As you can see, located in the back of the hot plate, there is a place to put this cord. You want to make sure the cord is in all the way in order for the hot plate to be turned on. After you have put in that cord, the next is to put in the other end of the cord into an outlet. Make sure that this end of the cord is also placed into the outlet correctly. If it has been done correctly, you will hear a beep sound coming from the hot plate. As you can see, there is a knob located on the left and the right. For the left is the heat. It lets you set your desired temperature. Place the substance onto the hot plate and set to your desired temperature. Notice that the numbers are blinking to show that the hot plate is preheating, and a light in the triangle will come on showing you it is hot. Now, the only thing left to do with the hot plate is wait until the substance you want to be heated is heated. As you can see, if you look closely, bubbles are starting to arise to the top. Now let's move on to the next step, stirring. Now it is time for stirring. If you have a hot plate, you will notice that this hot plate is equipped with a little white magnet. When placed into the substance and turned on using the right knob, the magnet will start to turn and stir the substance. Immediately as the knob is turned on and off, the magnet will automatically start and stop. With heating and stirring over with, now it is time to clean up. You first want to take out the back cord you originally put in and the cord from the outlet. When dealing with taking off the water, you want to use the mitt because glass doesn't show its temperature. It could still be really hot. Don't waste your time on me.